We got the spelling bee champ. We got the kid from Annie. And we got the 13-year-old going to UCLA. But we still need one more.
What about this? It's from the Swarita Elementary. It's from the Swarita Elementary School Bugle. Three sisters and a brother run a corporation called Kidco. They collect horse manure and sell it as fertilizer.
It's great, but it's not exactly appetizing, is it?
Executive Secretary Betty Cessna confided to the Bugle that this summer, Kidco cleared more than $6,000 a month.
Mm. Well done, lads. Now to quench our thirst.
No name.
I'm Robin Hood, a swashbuckling hero. I don't want beer, I want something special.
Bull! Bull? The Schlitz Malt Liquor Bull. It's a special premium brew that's in a class by itself.
What noble taste!
Robin, my son.
How about a little game of bumper pool?
If you want to change up pace with a big bold taste, don't say beer, say bull. Bull! The Schlitz Malt Liquor Bull!
I told him to go straight home. Hello, operator, could you get me the Maydeville police quickly?
Did you tell him?
Well, I wasn't sure what had happened. I just said I was feeling lousy. That's all. Darling, would you please go back to bed?
Sergeant Pearson?
Police, there's been a terrible accident.
So what sort of accident?
A man has been killed.
Your name, sir?
I'm Tony Wendis. I'm at 61A Charrington Gardens, ground floor flat.
And when was this accident?
About 2 minutes ago.
He must have broke in and he attacked my wife.
A burglar?
Yes, I'll explain all this to you when you get here. How long do you think that'll be?
About 2 minutes.
Look, don't touch anything, will you, sir?
No, of course. We won't touch anything. Thank you.
Is going to continue with your pieces on Free Love, H.G.?
Free Love sells newspapers. Gentlemen, I give you the Fleet Street Casanova.
Yeah.
Well, I've got my little experiments to pay for.
You're the hero of the working class, H.G. Free Love's the only sort they can afford.
Oh, Lord, don't start him on socialism in heaven's name. We'll have to listen to a sermon on the subject from Father Wells.
We'll be here all... You oughtn't to call it a sermon.
No, you've done
you
it.
Know I don't believe in organized religion. Socialism is the path mankind must inevitably tread on its way to a utopian society.
McKay's right, you know. We've heard all that. What's this great announcement you've brought us all to supper for?
Have you found the cure for gravity?
I think I'd prefer to wait until we were all here.
Who's missing?
Thought we were all here.
Dr. Stevenson is here, Mr. Wells.
Thank you very much, Mr. Late. Turner. Would you send him in?
After you with the poor old man. Good evening, John.
Gentlemen, good evening.
Hello.
Gentlemen, I have called you together tonight to bid you farewell.
Farewell? Where are you off to?
Going abroad? Well,
another holiday in Scotland, eh?
No. No, I am going traveling. But I'm not leaving London. Indeed, I do not expect to be leaving my laboratory.
Mm-hmm. Riddles again.
Gentlemen, I am talking about traveling through time. in a machine constructed for that very purpose.
Electric light, gentlemen.
Courtesy of Thomas Edison, the modern Prometheus.
Good heavens. You were really serious.
Good God. I don't believe it. You've actually built the bloody thing.
Well, free love has paid for most of it.
This cup catches the rays of the sun, converting its heat to electricity here. Electricity does the rest, juxtaposing fields of energy, creating friction. The result is an ever-increasing series of reactions that lifts or literally rotates the machine out of one time sphere into another. The cruising speed is 2 years per minute. You can go into the past or future at will.
2 years per minute.
Acceleration will keep the machine and its occupant outside all time spheres, in a conscious but vaporized state.
How do you determine which direction you journey?
Well, if you rotate to the west, you gain yesterday's. To the east, you accumulate tomorrow's.
Balderdash. Go north, you get to Glasgow.
I can't agree with you. Check. Really, you astonish me, H.G. In the midst of all your theorizing, you manage to ignore the fact.
The evidence of human history is that we live in a cosmic charnel house. Mankind has not changed for 2,000 years. We hunt, we're hunted. That's how it is. That's how it shall always be. The future will prove you wrong.
The future will tell. Anyway, I have just one question for myself. When do you leave?
I'm not sure.
Human frailty at last.
Oh. Well, to be quite candid, I haven't quite worked up the nerve.
First time HG ever lacked nerve.
No, but I will. All I've got to do is to set the date and activate the switches in sequence.
Of course you'll find it, and I'll inherit the Hope Diamond.
Checkmate, Herbert.
How does he do it?
Not again.
Every time.
Well, I know how he thinks, that's all.
One day I shall win.
Yes, when you learn how I think.
Oh, sorry to interrupt, Mr. Wells, but there are two gentlemen here from Scotland Yard who'd like a word with you.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
For the British contingent, Sergeant Barnstable and I have had a smashing Christmas.
Thanks. It's been a real hoot breaking bread with you two.
Come back when it's warmer. Maybe we can break the butter.
Last call for my mouth-watering turkey.
A bird that gave its life so that others might be ill.
Merry Christmas to you too, sir.
I didn't think the dinner was so bad. But then I'm in no condition to judge. This is my fifth powdered eggnog.
Better lay off. Your stomach will get powder burns. Much obliged for the gasoline, or petrol, as you boys like to put it. Should keep our generators generating till tomorrow's shipment.
Now just consider it our Christmas present. Well, we best be off.
Yes, we don't want to be late, do we? After all, it's Boxing Day tomorrow, isn't it?
Boxing Day? Who's fighting?
Absolutely no one. Klinger, in England, a country of which you may or may not have heard, the day after Christmas called Boxing Day. It's the custom for the masters and the servants of the manor to trade places.
And in the case of the military, the officers trade jobs with the other ranks. And you're enlisted men for a day.
Hey, that's my kind of tradition.
The only British tradition that's harder to swallow than mutton. No offense.
There's wonders for the morale in our unit, especially at this time of year with the lads being so far away from home.
From the long faces I see around here, you could do worse than to consider Boxing Day yourselves. Well, cheerio.
Sergeant?
Good luck, sir.
Fantastic. You know, Major Cass, those are the kind of ideas that keep the sun from setting on your umpire.
Quaint. Well, thanks very much.
Ta-ta.